Hello guys, welcome to our vlog. This is Alinor R. Amrudin, and our vlog is about entering Excel formulas and formatting data. Okay, so we will learn some operation like addition, subtraction, and subtract and multiply. Okay, so let's try to put some data in our cells. Okay, 8. For the under subtract, we have 25, 13. For the multiply, 11, and then 6, and then for the divide, 75, and then 5. Okay, so let's try to get the sum of the 12 and 8. Okay. 25 B2 minus B3. Okay, so that's 12. For the multiplication, let's try D2 divided by D3. Enter. Okay, so yun yung pagkuhaan ng perform ng operation sa Excel. Okay, so let's try to go to cell A. Divided by 2 times 4, enter. So that's 30. Okay, so let's try naman if example, if you would apply parentheses, for example, 3 plus 3 plus 3, ay hindi pala, 12, and then divided by 2 times 4. Okay, so you can see different yung answers nila because dito is walang present na parenthesis, dito is meron present na parenthesis. Okay, so for the auto sum, let's try 3 plus 3 plus 3. So paano natin makukuha yung sum nito? So we can get the sum of this 3 by just by using by using yung symbol na sum. So, as you can see, nakuha natin yung sum nila. So, this time we would learn about the alignment. For example, i-click natin yung... Okay, wait. Naghang. Okay, alignment. So, as you can see, nag-iba yung alignment ng word na add, subtract, multiply, and divide. Naging sa center na sila ng cell. So, this time we would learn how to copy at data. Example, this one, i-copy natin. Just right-click. Control-C. And then, dito, copy natin. Enter. Okay, let's try copying a data. For example, this one, i-click lang natin. Tiniklik natin yung dito. No? And then, paste natin dito. So, ayun, as you can see, na-copy natin yung data. And for cutting a data, for example, ito, hold natin. Tiniklik natin yung parang scissor na symbol sa home tab. Click natin, and then, click tayo sa cell H9. Then, i-click natin yung paste. As you can see, yung data natin dito kanina is na-transfer dito. So, this time, we would learn how to delete data from the cell. For example, ito sa cell F under F at saka G. For example, i-copy lang natin. I mean, i-hold natin siya pa. And then, delete. So, yun, na-delete na yung data natin from that cells. That is through column. And then, for row naman, for example, pag-delete natin is going siya dito. Delete. So, ayan. Yun, ganun yung pag-delete ng data through going parang okay, so as of now we will learn or work with a long text. For example, dito sa cell natin na A14 we write so much long text, which is now is the time for all good men to go to the aid of their army. So let's try to move to the cell B14 and type test. Okay, as you, nakita niyo yung data na sinulat natin sa A14 is naputol siya, but if we click it and tingnan natin yung sa formula bar is nandun yung long text na tinype natin kanina. Okay, so now we will learn how to change a column width. For example, i-click lang natin yung cell A14 and then go to a home tab and then go to format. And then i-select natin yung column width. So, let's try to type 55. Okay. So, as you can see, yung width ng cell natin is na parang na-transform siya into a width of 55. Okay, so another way of changing a column by width is by dragging. For example, if you will change the column of the cell na under B is try to click natin yung the line between B and C. As you can see, as we drag, is na-change yung width. So, let's try na 20. Okay, 20 and then yan. Na-change na yung width ng cell natin under B. Under column B rather. Okay, so as of now, we will learn about formatting numbers. So, for example, dito punta tayo dito sa cell B17 and let's try to type 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then, i-click natin yung Jake dito sa formula bar. And then, pumunta naman tayo sa mga and dito sa under number format. So, i-click lang natin yung number. As you can see, pag na mag-a-add siya ng 2 decimal places dun sa gi-enter natin na value. Okay. Ayun, no, nagdagdag siya ng 2 decimal places. The next thing na gagawin naman natin is i-click natin yung comma style. Ayun,
nadagdagan naman ng comma style. And then, i-click naman natin yung accounting number. Ito. Ayan. And then, let's try to click the increase decimal button. So, as we can see na parang nag-increase yung, nadadagdagan yung decimal places natin. Okay, so, let's try naman to click twice yung decrease decimal button natin. So, as you can see, lumit yung decimal places doon sa value natin. Okay. So, as of now, we will learn how to change a decimal into a percent. For example, we will try to type 0.35 under sa cell natin na D17. Okay. 0.35. Then, punta tayo sa home tab. Ay, wait. 0.35. And then, punta tayo sa home tab. Punta tayo sa home tab. Niklik natin yung percent na sign. So, as you can see, na-change yung 0.35 natin kanina into 35%. So, this is the end of our vlog. I hope you will learn something from me. And that's all. And thank you for watching.